Doctors found that Teresa had two wounds 4 years ago when they performed a complicated operation. The discovery then was only of academic interest because they believed the operation would prevent her from ever having children. Teresa and her husband Gordon, who'd been married for nearly 2 years, prepared themselves to adopt, but suddenly they were amazed to discover that she was pregnant. Their surprise was doubled when a hospital scan revealed two little heads bobbing around in individual wounds.
Your
My husband wouldn't believe me and took two trips to the doctors for him to realise that we had a baby as well.
Did they think at first that you were going to have twins?
Yeah, they've been classed as twins throughout pregnancy. You know, we'd never thought of them as anything else but twins because there was two. But obviously they're not twins because they are totally separate.
Has it been a difficult pregnancy?
Been very tired and had a lot of swellings and this sort of thing. They were quite heavy towards the end, and quite uncomfortable because they didn't have as much room as they should have had to move about. Very worrying because I didn't know, you know, what the situation was going to be with them. But, you know, I suppose the same as everybody else goes through, really.
What sort of emotions do you have now that you've got two new boys?
I'm thrilled. Absolutely thrilled. They're very good and they're lovely.
Can you actually tell the difference between them?
Yeah. We've nicknamed that one Bonzo.
Why is that? That's Nicholas, is it?
Yeah, Nicholas is Bonzo. He's got a slightly longer head, where he was crushed in the pelvis so far down. His head's a little bit distorted at the moment. But they're not really alike anyway.
Have you got any plans to have any more?
I'd like one more, but if it's possible to have one more, I certainly don't want two more.
Okay.
Do you think they're going to come in twos if you have any more?
I don't know. Nobody knows. You know, it is so rare that nobody knows. Mr. Shepherd's going to look into it a little bit further later on when I sort of recover from having these two, and we'll sort it out from there.
Teresa has been in Guy's Hospital for nearly 2 months now and is looking forward to going back home to Orpington with her new family. And her husband Gordon is planning a big celebration party for Simon and Nikki and the mum in a moon. Malcolm Brabant at Guy's Hospital for Thames News.
Good one. This is a good one. Oh, dear, look on yellow.
A bit joined. Excuse me.
Moving to some charming, are you? Oh, Nicky.
Right, well, Mrs. Ebers, if you can look at me, could you tell me, first of all, how did you think that you would never have children?
The hospital in Beckenham told me that I wouldn't have children due to a gynaecological problem. And that's how it all started. We sort of realised from there that we wouldn't. So we never gave up hope and just said, well, if it happens, it happens.
So how surprised were you when you found out you were pregnant?
Quite surprised. My husband wouldn't believe me and took two trips to the doctors for him to realise that we were going to have a baby, as we thought.
And what happened after that?
Well, we was living further away then, and I was told that I had to get in touch with the hospital if I did get pregnant at any time. And we moved back to Orpington, where I originally come from, and went to see my old GP, who trained at Queen Charlotte's, and he said that it was best to come to either Guy's or Queen Charlotte's, and I came here, and Mr. Shepherd found it all out from there.
He found out that you had two rather than one?
Yeah.
What sort of a surprise was that?
Complete shock. Absolutely amazing. Just never thought of it.
Did they think at first that you were going to have twins?
Yeah, they've been classed as twins throughout pregnancy. You know, we'd never thought of them as anything else but twins because there was two. But obviously they're not twins because they are totally separate.
When exactly did you find out that you had two wombs?
About 4 years ago when I had the gynae up.
And did the doctors then ever imagine that you would have two babies in separate wombs?
No.
Does it feel any different, actually?
I don't know, because I don't know what it feels like normally. No.
Has it been a difficult pregnancy?
Been very tired and had a lot of swellings and this sort of thing. They were quite heavy towards the end, but quite uncomfortable because they didn't have as much room as they should have had to move about, you know. Very worrying because I didn't know, you know, what the situation was going to be with them. But, you know, I suppose the same as everybody else goes through, really.
What sort of emotions do you have now that you've got two new boys?
I'm thrilled. Absolutely thrilled. They're very good and they're lovely. Yeah.
Can you actually tell the difference between them?
Yeah. We've nicknamed that one Bonzo.
Why is that? That's Nicholas, is it?
Yeah, Nicholas is Bonzo. He's got a slightly longer head, where he was crushed in my pelvis so far down that his head's a little bit distorted at the moment. But they're not really alike anyway.
What's the big difference between them?
They're very different personalities. Even at this early age, you can pick that up. One feeds well, one feeds not well. And one's a bit finicky and the other one isn't. You know, little things like that, and you can sort them out. But they don't really look alike anyway, so it's not that hard.
What does your husband think of them?
He's over the moon, absolutely thrilled. He was crying when I came out of the theatre, that's how thrilled he was.
Yeah. Have you shed any tears yourself?
Yeah, yesterday, yeah. I sat down for the first time yesterday and really sort of looked at them, and I cried, yeah.
You were planning to actually adopt some children, I believe, weren't you?
Yes, we were thinking about it because, you know, we both wanted children anyway, and we were sort of thinking along the lines, but we didn't know whether we'd be suitable because it is so hard. And as I say, we just kept on trying, and eventually we got there.
Have you got any plans to have any more?
I'd like one more, but if it's not possible to have one more, I certainly don't want two more.
Do you think they're going to come in twos if you have any more?
I don't know. Nobody knows. You know, it is so rare that nobody knows. Mr. Shepherd's going to look into it a little bit further later on when I sort of recover from having these two, and we'll sort it out from there.
I think that'll do us lovely. Perfect.
Right. What's